Hi, welcome to the fourth lecture of the chapter Quantum Chemistry. Today we are going to study the important point wave particle duality, or it is also called as de Broglie's hypothesis. Now see, what is de Broglie's hypothesis? So de Broglie stated that like photons, all microscopic particles such as atom, molecules and subatomic particles like electron and proton also possess dual character. Okay, so what de Broglie stated? He stated that photons shows dual character, and similar to photons, all microscopic particles like atom, molecules and subatomic particles like electron and proton also possess dual character. Now, what is mean by dual character? Dual character means wave-like nature as well as particle-like nature. See, the wave associated with the particle is called a matter wave or de Broglie wave. Hence, de Broglie's hypothesis is called pillar of quantum mechanics. So what is the importance of de Broglie's hypothesis? It is a pillar of quantum mechanics. Now see, we know that according to Planck's quantum theory, in case of photon, if it assumes to have wave character, its energy is given by E is equal to h nu. So we have studied it in a last lecture, that is when a photon has wave character, at that time, according to Planck's quantum theory, energy is equal to h nu, where h is Planck's constant, while nu is the frequency of the wave. So this is our equation 1. And according to Einstein's equation, if the photon is supposed to have particle character, its energy is given by E is equal to mc square. So we have now two equations for energy. First one is E is equal to h nu. Here that equation is due to wave character of photon, while second equation we have E is equal to mc square, it is due to the particle character. So both are the equations of energy. Therefore, from equation 1 and 2 we can write h nu is equal to mc square, but we know that nu is equal to c upon lambda. Therefore, hc upon lambda is equal to mc square. Now rearrange this equation for lambda. So lambda is equal to hc upon mc square. So lambda is equal to h upon mc. So this is our equation third. Now what is the importance of this equation? See, de Broglie pointed out that the above equation third, that is that lambda is equal to h upon mc, is applicable to any material particle. We can apply that equation to any material particle. The mass of photon is replaced by the mass of material particle, that is m, and the velocity of photon c is replaced by the velocity of material particle, that is v. Thus, for any material particle like electron, we may write equation as lambda is equal to h upon mv. So this equation third, which is we have written lambda is equal to h upon mc, we can replace that c by v. Therefore, equation 4 is lambda is equal to h upon mv. Now that mass into velocity mv, it is nothing but the momentum, that is p. So mv is equal to p, that is momentum of the particle. So finally we have equation lambda is equal to h upon p. That equation 4 is called de Broglie's equation, and lambda is called de Broglie's wavelength. Okay, so thus the significance of de Broglie's equation lies in the fact that it relates the particle character with the wave character of matter. So we have to remember that significance. What is the significance of de Broglie's equation? It relates the particle character with the wave character of matter. Okay, so in today's lecture we have studied important point, that is de Broglie's hypothesis. What is hypothesis? Like photons, all microscopic particles such as atom, molecules and subatomic particles like electron and proton also possess dual character. Dual character means wave-like as well as particle-like character, and we have proved it by the equations of energy, that E is equal to h nu, E is equal to mc square. So finally we arrived at h lambda is equal to h upon p. So finally we have seen what is the significance of de Broglie's equation. It relates the particle character with the wave character of matter. So this is all about the de Broglie's hypothesis. Thank you.